behalf of our women's group, Antigua and Barbuda Network of Women Producers, I was glad to be here for this workshop today. It's very encouraging and it's stated upon building capacity in using your pepper, your hot pepper, and how to store it so in order you'll have it for future use just in case the peppers are not available. It's an eye-opener and I've learned a lot and hope that while we're here today we'll pass it on for greater dimension.
My name is Teresa Callis. I'm from Grenada, representing Grenada as a rural women's group. And I would like to say that this workshop was very interesting to me because I learned a lot about it and expecting to do more when I get to do the pepper sauce. It's very interesting to me because right now I could go back home and able to tell the other women what I have learned in that workshop and also able to help them to improve what I have learned. I don't want to keep everything for myself. I want to share it with the others. And I'm very thankful for that opportunity. It gave me the great pleasure to really be here.
My name is Hamelin Frederick. I'm from Grenada, representing the Grenada group. It's a women's group organization. And being here is a great opportunity, you know, to learn the new skills, techniques that we go back and apply to our pepper sauce in Grenada and bring knowledge to the rest of the group.
Good morning. My name is Daisy Bailey, a teacher at Austin Secondary School in the Home Economics Department and also representing the Antigua and Barbuda Home Economics Association.
Deborah Hughes, head of department at the Antigua Grammar School Home Economics.
Lauren Davis, food and nutrition teacher also in secondary school and also a member of the Antigua and Barbuda Home Economics Association.
We really appreciate this workshop. It has added new insight into, you know, doing the pepper mashes. It's not something that we do at our school. But I like the idea where we can share with our students a way forward into their own entrepreneurship. And if they should go on and, you know, become farmers in themselves, they can, you know, take their produce in processing them. They would have all the details, how to formulate labels, all the chemistry and, you know, all the different things that they would need to have a more successful business.
Learning some of the things that we would have discussed over the last 2 days. We would have looked at different areas where maybe things that are not being done correctly, that need to be done correctly, and we can pass that information on to our students as well. Even if they're doing small scale production, let them start from that small scale doing the correct thing.
As the president of the association, we do hope that we can pass on this knowledge and have a similar workshop with the teachers to enlighten them. Because some of our teachers are into agro-processing and it will just further develop their skill sets and to produce better products.
And I'm Latoya Reynolds and we're farmers with the CAFAN organization and we are both blessed to have benefited from the pepper mash workshop. Through this workshop we will be able to connect with producers of pepper products and we'll be able to supply them as farmers with not just peppers but with also the mash. It was amazing to be able to make these connections and now we are able to link directly with those persons who produce these pepper products and we're able to provide them with a price and consistent goods and they're able to provide us with consistent sales. Very fortunate, as I said before, to be a part of this organization which benefited from the pepper mash workshop.
So now the only thing left for us to do now is to just go back to our organization and share this information with everyone so that everyone can benefit as well from this exercise that we take part in today.
My name is Dr. Ian Lambert. I'm a professionally trained food scientist and I have been here facilitating the workshop on best practices in hot pepper mash and hot pepper sauce production in the agro-processing sector and also for entrepreneurs. Some of the things, topics that we looked at and covered are basically best practices in hot pepper sauce production, prerequisite programs and other programs that are required for establishing a food processing facility. We also looked at post-harvest handling and processing operations in packing houses for hot pepper sauce. Also looked at practical aspects of good hygienic practices and good manufacturing practices in pepper sauce production. We have also been able to address labeling aspects of it as done by the Antigua and Barbuda Bureau of Standards. And we also look at how one arrives at nutritional facts and nutritional labeling. Probably the highlight of the entire program was actually the hands-on practicals that we did in determining properties or critical properties of hot pepper sauce. For example, pH, the importance of pH, the importance of consistency using the Bostwick consistometer, and also looking at the need for knowing the types of acidity of hot pepper sauce. We also made pepper mash, and the participants would have taken that away and make hot pepper sauce in the future. It has been a fascinating experience for me, especially being in the wonderful facilities at the Hospitality Training Institute here in Antigua.